had some kind of a problem. He just went by the start-finish line. All right, Schwartz is in front, and Cooley is coming up to challenge. Wesco now is suddenly coming alive and coming up right behind Kevin Schwartz. Brubaker is right behind Cooley, running the fastest lap time so far in this race. Brubaker down the front straightaway. Here they come. Suzuki followed by three Hondas into turn number one. Kevin Schwartz in front, Cooley second, Todd Brubaker third, and flying Fred Merkel in fourth. An ailing flying Fred, we might add. Schwartz pull away. He's about a bike length behind him into turn three. Cooley has taken the lead. Cooley, and going into turn two. Thank you, Wes Cooley Sr., for that bit of information. Merkel comes up behind Brubaker. 16 laps now. Remember, we are in lap number five. They're down the back straightaway. Cooley in front. Here's where that Yoshimura Suzuki horsepower makes a difference. And Schwartz goes by him. Cooley is going to have to outride him in the turns. But he's going to have enough of a lead coming out of turn nine to pull off the win in his first leg. And make no mistake, Cooley would like nothing better than to beat the Yoshimura Suzuki. They come down the front straightaway. Kevin Schwartz in front. Ladies and gentlemen, not too many changes. 21 has come up very strong. Earl Roloff has rolled his way into about 8th place. Roloff has gone up to 8th, number 21. That's about the only major changes happening back in the pack. Kevin Schwartz still in front in a high-speed ballet of motorcycle road racing at Willow. The Kirker 100 Superbike Race. They come on the back straightaway. Through turn eight, now into turn number nine. Kevin Schwartz still in front, Cooley in second. Third spot is Merkel. Merkel now moving up a little bit behind Cooley. Onto the front straightaway. Brubaker in fourth. Here's the clock. We got a clock on Schwartz now. We'll find out what he's doing. Starting coming up now. Merkel is going for second! Merkel goes by Cooley. He's got second. They are side by side, and Merkel goes out in front. Merkel in second now. Oh, mama! Merkel suddenly tucked in behind Cooley and used the draft to flip around him. And went by him like a snake oil salesman in the night. Kevin Schwartz in front. Merkel is running second, suddenly coming alive. Cooley third, Brubaker fourth. Superbike race on the west coast of 1985. Lockhart 600 Super Street Bikes to the pre-grid, please. Lockhart 600 Super Street Bikes to the pre-grid, please. Incidentally, the pictures that were taken yesterday and today, Skip O'Brien has got them. Circle B Photography is down here in this green and white camper just to the right of the Toyota building here by the announcer stand. You want to get your pictures. Cooley right up behind Merkel now. Cooley Bird ES 4Z1202. See the referee. Come to the pre-attack inspection area. Go see the referee at tech inspection right now. Cooley has gone back to second. They're coming up on lap riders now. Kevin Schwantz still in front. Here comes Merkel coming up right behind Cooley, leaning way over at 150 miles an hour. They are nose to tail. Going into turn number 9 now. Kevin Schwantz in front. Down the front straightaway they come. Starting to come up here at Willow, and that could be a factor. It could come up underneath the fairing on these super bikes and pick them up, lift up the front wheel. SoCal Arcade Dunlop and Indy spark plugs. He has been racing for 12 years. Until last year, he was an amateur. He is not an amateur now. You can ask Cooley and Merkel that. They'll confirm it. Because there is another leg at about 3:30 this afternoon. Going into that finish line area to let Cooley Cooley feel that he can pass him, or that Cooley can pull away from him at the finish line? That may be strategy on Merkel's part. Good point. Terry, our scorer, just pointed out Merkel sat up momentarily before he got to the finish line. We'll find out. Larry Shorts pushing his bike back in turn number three, number 25. Larry Shorts apparently has taken it in the shorts. The final lap. In front, Kevin Schwantz, but watch the strategy in seconds. Okay, they're coming down the hill now on the back straightaway. Kevin Schwantz way out in front. Nothing's going to stop him short of a howitzer right now to take the win in this first leg. But Cooley and Merkel are going to stay with them. They're down the back straightaway about 150 miles an hour. Now Merkel is moving up behind Cooley. Turn number eight and heading for turn nine. Kevin Schwantz is going to win it. Watch the battle for second. Here they come. Merkel sitting right behind Cooley in turn number nine. There's Schwantz. He's got it. Now watch the battle. There he is down the front straightaway. Handlebar. Honda versus Honda. It is going to be Merkel. Sammy, that's exactly what Merkel did. He set up Cooley and went right by him on the final lap when it counted.
Going down the back straightaway, he was about 10 lengths behind, and as he started entering the turn, he started just cutting it away until he had a drive on Cooley coming out of that turn. He had momentum, so he could catch him at that line.
He did indeed, and he did a very good job. So flying, Fred Merkel goes into second with an overall shot at the win. Kevin Schwantz is way out in front. He's walking on air right now. It is the final finish, ladies and gentlemen, unofficial now, pending any kind of protest or anything. We have to say it's unofficial, but the first leg, Kevin Schwantz is on his way to the history books, winning his first superbike race. Kevin Schwantz finishing first, flying Scott Gray in fifth spot.
I didn't think Schwantz would dominate the race that much. I thought it would be a lot closer, but Schwantz, I think, has raced his track more this year than any of the other riders out there, despite Brubaker. But Schwantz has been out here for a couple of local races earlier in the year, and he knows this track real well, and he's prepared for it. Very, very well.
He certainly has, and Kevin Schwantz, one tough little cookie out of Houston, Texas. Roman McMurder, the Canadian champion, was sixth in sixth place. Bike number 80, Malcolm Hill, was sponsored by Ed Toomey's Motorcycle Center in Hermosa Beach.
We're going to see about three riders. I'm going to try and make this through, Larry. I got a real bad sore throat, but we'll hang in.